Okay, here I am in front of the Imperial Palace in the center of Tokyo, near Ginza, because this is a cool background and makes my life in Japan even more stereotypically in Japan than it really is. I'm off to meet five Swedes tonight. They've flown in and they need some help, so I said, hey, you know, five Austin Swedes, how could I not help out? I just hope they're like bikini models or something. Maybe beach volleyball players. Do they have beach volleyball in Sweden? I don't know. I don't think we even have beaches, really. Anyway, hopefully the night will end with drunken ABBA in a karaoke box. I'm going to take them to Yurakucho, which is right near here. We can get like chicken on the stick and sit outside. It's a very, very cool, funky atmosphere. Cool place to be. And they're here.
Hello.
Names?
Adam. Hi, I'm Simon. Nice to meet you.
Adam and?
Rune.
What was that?
Again?
Rune. Okay, yeah.
And Petrus.
And now, me and our new Swedish Viking comrades are going to get drunk on some beer.
Skål!
It's something to experience.
Great food. Great clubs, funny people. Japan is something everyone should have, you know, gone to once in their life.
Shibuya girls, definitely.
Kobe beef, like fine meat.
Most things were surprisingly good. Surprisingly easy to learn the subway system. It's a very, very big town, but we've got to hang with it in like 3 days.
I've heard about Japanese hospitality, but I mean the level they go through to please you and to make you like, feel welcome, it's amazing.
Freshest burger!
Good.
Really good.
Probably be at the meat place, I don't know what it's called, but tenderloin and stuff. We ate so much meat, we ate a whole plate.
Whale. I'm not the only person who eats whale. Evidently these Northern Europeans have no qualms about eating whale as well. How is that?
Whale?
Yeah.
And we knew it's kind of illegal to eat in Sweden.
I didn't expect the whale to be as meaty as it was. It was more fish-like, but it was still delicious.
And don't bring too much of your own food, because they got everything here. They got all the major brands, they got their own brands, and everything is so high quality and cheap compared to Sweden. So I really recommend the shopping here.
The Yogi Park in Karaoke.
It's Marikyu.
Tokyo Tower, kind of cool.
Club Atom in Shibuya.
Go to Nikko and visit the Hudson Springs Spa. Mm-hmm.
Gotta go to all of the Sega arcade centers. They have this incredible game.
Don't visit the main, the malls and stuff. Go into the side streets and find small shops. That's great.
One of the best tips that we have is that the only place where you can exert money in Tokyo is 7-Eleven. They got their own bank, and so that's like the only place for gaijins to use their Visa cards.
Swedish people are not just a stereotype like IKEA and ABBA. They're really, I don't know, unique. Isn't it great job?
You are the dancing queen, young and sweet, only 17. Sleeping, worry about the things that are not
Anyway, other news. I have finally updated my website and put a whole bunch of new crap on there, video that's not on YouTube, and a blog, which you should definitely check out because it's got basically lots of cool stuff. I've been writing for this thing. I don't know how long I'm going to be writing it or how long I'm going to do it, but I've been doing it for the last 3 weeks, a weekly opinion piece about whatever I think about Tokyo for the Metropolis magazine's Metpod podcast. It's very cool. Lots of great information about Tokyo, so I definitely recommend checking that out. Maybe I'll bring the camera in there and film something there at some point, too, it's like. But Metropolis magazine, I'll put a link to it here on this video, is like the, I don't know, the gaijin Bible of Tokyo. It's got all the information about what's going on in the city, so you should definitely, if you're visiting the town, check that out. And anyway, time to go eat some chicken with Swedish people. Booyah!
Whisper words of wisdom, let it be.